In this tutorial, I want to show you a few tricks how you can make the eyes really outstanding and that they look even more interesting. And first of all, maybe you like the idea that you change the color of the iris overall. And for that, you have obviously different options. You can play here with your color balance, for example, maybe in the midtones to see, okay, how would it look like if the eyes are a bit more cool, maybe blue or cyan or something like that. And then, this might be now an interesting look. However, the problem is that the look is now over the whole image, and it might be a bit difficult to judge if that would work with the rest of the image as a color. So rather than just bringing the effect over the whole image, you would like to work probably with a selection. And there are different ways of doing so. You could just circle the eye in as a whole and then see what that looks like, but then you still have to mask it out. And yeah, there's so many ways you can play with paths or whatever, but I really like the quick mask tool because, as I said, I'm not really that interested in creating complicated masking areas like what you would do for a composite, maybe, where you cut people out. So therefore, the quick mask, that sounds like a good tool to use because it's quick. And therefore, I go now into my tool area down here. And first of all, you want to double click onto this area, because if you never used the quick mask option, then it probably is ticked on this side here where it says masked area. But you want that it's the selected area, and you could change the color here, but I think the red is quite good. And then the opacity with 100%, that's good as well. And for that, first of all, I just bring the layer one more time onto its own image layer, and then I go in here and say okay. You can also use Q for quick mask. And now with the black color, you will paint the red in, and if you want to fix anything, you switch the colors around and then you paint with white. So let me just see how fast that goes. So yeah, maybe a hardness from 12 or something, because you don't want it too soft. You do want to select pretty much the iris, and let's say okay, the size should be fairly good as well, maybe something like this. You can obviously also zoom in a bit more, something like this, just fairly quick. And if you think you went a bit overboard with white, you can just switch around, and then again with the X, you switch around, and then you just paint over the area once more. So that is now your selection here. If I press Q, then this will drop me out. And now I go into my color balance again. And if I try now and see, okay, let me see what that was like, if the eye is a bit more cyan or cyan, I'm not quite sure, cyan, cyan, whatever, and a bit more blue, then yeah, now I get maybe a better feeling for the overall look. And if I just go out of the image a bit, now I can just judge a little bit easier if I like this overall eye color now, depending on the image. So if I go before and after, now I think, oh yeah, that might be just a little bit of a funky effect, and that's quite nice. Maybe it's a bit too dramatic, and then I can just lower this also down. So that's just one quick tip on the quick mask tool, which I think is really good. Then I don't have to bother about circling anything or selecting anything. So I'm just painting on it, and then it does the selection for me. If at any time you're not quite happy with the selection, you can always also just feather this and smooth this down. You just go over then your select, and then you go into select and mask. And here you could also play with the smoothness, the feather, the contrast, in case you're not quite happy with it. But I think for here, that's not necessary. That looks quite good. So that's definitely one really good option, just to play with the eye color a bit and to bring the eyes alive. The other way was obviously that we also did before, where you can also just paint onto the eye when you say, okay, the inside might be a bit more interesting if I paint there with white. So let's do this as well. So maybe also again with 12% and maybe 50% opacity. Something like this, fairly quick. And here again, you can just play with the blending mode. You could say now on screen, what would that be like if you just reduces down a bit. So that could also be interesting if you really want to have this eye a little bit more, like sparkling, like maybe even like 11%, just so it's a bit more shiny. Or you could also obviously just see if different effects might be interesting, like soft light might be also good, or even with the color here, but I don't think that does a lot because it's just white. That's just too minimalistic to even see. Yeah, so as I said, there are like different ways. I think with luminosity also it could work when you just have 10% or 12%. So yeah, I think to switch the color or to change the color in an eye, that's quite an interesting effect. And obviously if you just paint it a bit with white, then you just have this eye that's a bit more, yeah, I don't know, sparkling, so to say. So the next thing you might want to try is also, yeah, depends really on you if you think it's necessary or not. I mean, I quite like when the eyeball is not, well, if it stays a bit more natural. As I said before, if you just brighten this too much, it can also look a bit like a zombie. So I would keep this as natural as possible. However, maybe to just, yeah, brighten it a little bit in case there is some kind of discoloration or something like that. If it looks too yellowish or if it's too reddish, depending on the person, that, yeah, could maybe be also beneficial just to brighten this a little bit. And for that we can just use the same thing that we thought that would work with the hair. We could just bring it into the screen mode. So if I just bring this up again, so anytime I use the blending mode screen, obviously everything becomes a lot brighter. And yeah, you can do a lot of things with that. Like I said, it's a different option again. If you don't want to use the dodge and burn tool, you can use the screen mode here and just brighten things partially, like we said, with the hair, maybe if you see the roots, or as I want to do now here with the eyeball. And for that we just want to mask this first off. So if I just go onto Alt or Option onto my mask tool, I have once more my black mask, and now with my brush and maybe 10%, so we don't go too crazy, and my hardness can be now by, yeah, I think 0. Maybe 10 is too little, maybe 30. Yeah, why don't we try 30? I think that's good. Now you can also just brighten this a little bit, especially if the eyes are really red or, yeah, just too muddy. Maybe even a bit more. It's easy to go overboard, so, because when you zoom in, it looks pretty good. And when you zoom out, it's already a bit too obvious. So if I go before, after, yeah, I'm not a huge fan of the eyeball gets too much attention, because as we said, anything that's light gets the attention, and to bring, yeah, attention to an eyeball, I'm not so sure about that. But I think maybe with 40%, then it looks just a little bit better. And if you're still worried that there are like veins in the eye, then we can also just zoom in here, and there are different options again. So either you can try if you just paint over them very lightly with a spot healing brush. So that might be an option. Yeah, sometimes it gets a bit edgy though. So maybe I would rather do the healing brush tool where you actually pick a color, because there are so many like little details in here. It might be a bit problematic for the spot healing tool to pick up these nuances. So if you define the color, it might be better. You can also try the same trick that we tried with the wrinkle, where you go into clone and you go into your lighten mode here, where you can also just lighten some of these areas here where it's red. We can also see how would it be overall if we just minimize the redness here. So if we just go into our hue and saturation and pick the color here, yeah, it actually says it's also yellow, and here it's obviously more red. So let's just reduce the red just a little bit. And then also the yellow just a little bit, something like that. And then I mask this in again with Command and I, and with B, I just brush this out. I don't want to obviously desaturate it too much. It's just so that it doesn't look too reddish or yellow, because then the eye can also just look a little bit inflamed. And the other way is also if we just pick a color like that, because there's not a lot of, well, the detail is there, but just in the veins. And normally you don't really notice any other real detail in the eyeball. So you can get even away with it if you just paint lightly over it, maybe with 20%, not 20% here. That stays at 100%. Oh, come on, 100, yeah. So with 20%, or 30%. Now let's try 20 first, and then we just pick a color and we just lightly brush over these little veins, and then we just smooth it out this way. That might also be a good job. So something like that. It's always easy to overdo this because you zoomed in too close and then it looks good, but you really want to also zoom out to see if you didn't go on too crazy. But yeah, I think this is nice now, because now we still have a little bit of these veins, because if you don't have any in the eyes, that's also a bit like a robot or something. So normally humans have a little bit of veins here, but we just don't want that it's so noticeable. So I think this looks now pretty good.